Another one of the rules for exponents that we need to look at is called the quotient rule. The quotient rule says that if you have x to the a divided by x to the b, that you find the quotient by keeping the base x and taking a and subtracting b. It is always the top exponent minus the bottom exponent. Let's take a look at an example. Suppose you had x to the fifth over x to the second. Well, that's x times x times x times x times x over x times x. Well, you could divide out a pair of x's, divide out another pair of x's. That would leave you with three factors of x or x to the third. You could also have gotten that by taking 5 minus 2. You might be wondering what happens if the bottom exponent is larger. That's when we start getting into negative exponents. What happens if they're the same? We get zero exponent, and we will talk about those in future lessons. But let's use the quotient rule. I have x to the 14th over x. Now these do have to be the same base, and they are. Remember that this is an implied 1, so this will be x to the 14 minus 1, which you can do in your head. It's x to the 13th. Next, I have p to the 6th, q to the 9th, over p to the 4th, q to the 7th. Same base. That's going to give me p to the 6 minus 4, q to the 9 minus 7, which is p to the 2nd, q to the 2nd. Next, 6, I believe that is g to the 3rd, a to the 5th, over 36, g to the 3rd, a. Now, with the 6 and the 36, those are coefficients, you can't divide 36 into 6. You would have to reduce it. 6 goes in there once, 6 goes in there 6 times. So I have a 1 and a 6. The g to the third over g to the third, because those are the same, they divide out. And then you have a to the fifth over a to the implied first, which is a to the fourth. It sits on top. So how would you write this? Probably not like this. 1 times a to the fourth is a to the fourth. So this would be written as a to the fourth over 6. All right, let's look at one more problem. This looks real familiar. I have p to the fifth, q to the fifth, over p to the third, q to the third. Subtract, keep the p, 5 minus 3 is 2. Q, keep the q, 5 minus 3 is 2. I have p to the second, q to the second. All of those are using the quotient rule.